Good morning, students. I am here to take the lesson that is improvement in food resources ahead. And today, my topic for discussion is grain storage. You all are already aware how the crop variety can be improved, how the crop production can be managed, what are the essential factors that affect the production of crops. You also know how crops can be protected and who all are the enemies of the crops. Now, after the protection of the crops have been done, then they are harvested in the harvesting time. And after harvesting, the farmer needs to store them, that too properly. And how can he do that? We will talk all about that in today's lecture. So let us start with the topic storage of grains in the chapter improvement in food resources. Now, storage of grains. Most crops are harvested only once a year, so they are available in plenty during a selective time. For getting seasonal foods regularly throughout the year, they need to be stored in safe storage conditions. And storage of the grains happens in different levels. That is, you know, the farmer stores the grains after harvesting. Then when he sells the grains to the trader, then the trader also stores the grains, usually in the gunny bags. And then the trader may sell it to the government organizations like FCI, and there also it is done by storing in a gunny bag or in big silos, and they are kept in very big long areas that is called as the warehouses, whereby these gunny bags are piled one on top of another and it is kept safely over there by the government. Now, there are certain factors, you know, which are responsible for causing losses to our grains. So, we will study those factors, namely under two heads. That is your biotic factor and the abiotic factor. Now, among the biotic factors, we have the insects, the rodents, fungi, mites, bacteria. And in the abiotic factor, we have the moisture content, that is effect of moisture and temperature in the place of storage and also in case of grains. So these factors, what do they do if they are not in a properly, if they are not managed properly? They actually cause a degradation in the quality of the grains. That is, there is a loss in the weight of the grains, and all these things leads to poor marketability. So what is poor marketability? It is a condition in which the farmer does not get proper price, the right price for his produce. That means he has to sell his crops at a low price. So in order that the farmer does not face all these problems, he can go for certain preventive and control measures. That is what is we are going to discuss and study today. So in general, we can say that he needs to clean the produce. That is, when the crops are harvested, he needs to clean it properly before storing. Then he needs to dry those seeds. Then he may be using certain chemicals so that the insects and pests can be kept away. That is, they do not come near the place where these grains are stored. That means these chemicals may act as repellents. In other words, what we can say is they will repel these insects and pests from coming towards the storage area. So now let us talk about these factors in detail. Talking about the biotic. Now, biotic word means all those factors which is concerning the living organisms, those organisms which is going to affect the crop, which are going to affect the crops. They may be insects, they can be rodents. Rodent means these groups of animals, that is your rabbits, it can be rats, squirrels, moles. They are very dangerous because you know they all feed on these grains, so they love to eat these grains. Then we have the fungi, then the mites and bacteria. Bacterial infection can happen anywhere. Among the abiotic factors, that is that which is from the nature, that is the content of moisture in the environment and also the temperature at the place of storage, and also that is your temperature of the grains and moisture content of the grains. These things have to be taken in mind, kept in mind. So, what happens if these things are not controlled by us? Then they will lead to fall in the quality of grains, loss in the weight of grains. Germinability will be very poor, that is, the seeds will not germinate when they are put in the soil. And there they will lose their natural color. They will become discolored, and all these factors put together will lead to poor marketability. That is, the farmer will not get the right price for his efforts, for his produce. So, we can definitely control these factors. How can we do it? By giving it a proper treatment. Treating the grains properly, managing the warehouses properly, that is the actual area of storage of the grains. Then cleaning the produce properly, that is when the seeds are produced, we need to clean them because along with the grains, you know, so many other things may be collected at the time of harvesting, and those things may not be good for the quality of the grains, so they need to be removed. So strict cleaning is advised, and then proper drying of the produce is to be done. Now, how the drying will happen? Drying happens first in the sun and then in the shade. Both these drying procedures are very important. It is not that only in sunlight is sufficient. It has to be dried in the shade as well for 2 to 3 days. And the last option is fumigation using chemicals. And chemicals are never advisable. That is the last option that the farmer can adopt. Now, in this slide, you can see the pictures of some of the insect pests, that is, that those who are a danger to the stored grains. I have picked up some pictures: pulse beetle, rice weevil, Khapra beetle, grain and flour moth, rice moth, rust red flour moth, lesser grain borer. All these are the different pests, you know, that attack the grains. Now, here I just, in the form of points, I'm just going to discuss what are the preventive and control measures that needs to be adopted before we go for the storage of food grains. First thing that we need to do is, as soon as the food grains are harvested, they should be dried. Not on the ground, but they should be spread over plastic sheets. Because, you know, ground also contains a lot of moisture. And that moisture may get transferred into the seeds. And moisture is really a big danger for the seeds. They can be dried on cemented floor as it does not release any moisture. But if it is on the soil, then it should be spread only on plastic sheets. After the sun-dried food grains are done, then they are allowed to cool to room temperature. And then they have to be kept in the shade for few days. then only they are ready for storage. Second thing is that the produce, that is after harvesting, the grains have to be cleaned properly before their storage and before being filled up in the gunny bags and being sent to the godowns and the warehouses or the storehouses. And the bags should absolutely be dry and clean, free from dirt and webbing. So what is webbing? Webbing means formation of web by the spiders, you know, make a web. And when this webbing happens, you know, it attracts lot of insects. So it is actually an invitation. So these areas should be prevented. Actually, this area should be properly disinfected. Before keeping the bags stored with grains. Then godowns and warehouses should be cleaned and they should be disinfected and dried and also repaired. You know, many a time we find holes, cracks, crevices around that warehouses and godowns. So they need to be repaired so that these grains, these warehouse, these crops can be stored properly. Those pesticides which destroy the insects by forming toxic fumes are called fumigants. And fumigant application is the last option. And actually it is a chemical treatment. And we have fumigants of three categories: solid, liquid and gaseous. In solid fumigant, we have aluminium phosphate, very commonly available in the market. Then in the liquid fumigant, we have ethylene dichloride, carbon tetrachloride, what we call it as EDCT. And in the gaseous fumigant, we have methyl bromide. So all these things can be used whereby fumes will be produced and those fumes repel those insects and pests of the grains. Now, coming back, in this slide, what I have tried to show you is the crops are grown according to the season. So the crops that are sown during the monsoon, they are called as kharif crops. And the crops which are sown after the monsoon, they are called as rabi crops. Now here I have given you two examples, paddy and maize in case of kharif crop, and mustard and potato in case of rabi crop. So according to the season at which these crops are grown, we have mainly two types of crops, kharif and rabi, though we also have a third variety that is called as a zayad crops. Okay. Now in this flow chart, I have just tried to summarize all that we have talked about: crop production and crop management and protection and storage and everything. So let us start summarizing what all we have learnt till this class. That is, first thing is, before the seeds have to be sown into the soil, the bed has to be prepared. That is called as preparation of the soil, whereby plowing is done, summer plowing is done, and so that the soil becomes loosened with the help of certain implements, or animals may be used for preparing the bed for the sowing of the soil, for the sowing of the seed. Then in the second step, the sowing of the seed happens. Then sowing can be done manually or it can be done with the seed drill or some machines. Then after the seeds have been sown, then the soil is treated with manures and fertilizers to enrich it so that the seeds start growing fast. As the soil may be deficient of manures or important nutrients, so these manures and fertilizers are applied so that all the deficient nutrients are replenished. Then farmer has to ensure proper water supply as well, because without water seeds will not germinate, and if they don't germinate they will not grow. So irrigation facilities have to be looked after, And then when the once the seeds have germinated and the crops start growing, then along with the crops, we have the unwanted crops also growing. That is what we call as the weeds. So weeding is to be done either with the help of a kurpa, trowel, or by applying that is your chemical weedicides or organic weedicides, whatever ways and means the farmer finds convenient, he uses that to do the weeding. Then after the weeding is done, then proper protection of the crops is also undertaken so that the crops do not get attacked by the pests and insects. And once the crops are ready, they are ready, then the farmer goes for harvesting. The harvesting season arrives. After the harvesting is done, then the last part of the farmer's work is preservation and storage. This topic is what we have discussed in detail today. So he has to implement certain measures. He has to do certain things so that the storage of the grains happen properly and there are minimum losses. So that is all we have to study in this crop part. Now the second part of this improvement in food resources is animal husbandry, which we will be taking up in the next class. That's all. Thank you.